focus is on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech.
I think one of the most important things we need to do is start valuing the little child. The value of the girl child, unfortunately, has never been the same as a boy. First of all, हम लोग अभी अंदर discuss कर रहे थे कैसे लड़की पर आयरन होती है और these little things that that are set in the mindsets of people from when girl children are born, that their opportunities are only different, that the opportunity for a girl is never considered, she'll never consider a norm out of normal ambition because as a girl she's not supposed to do it. So the way I always see is that the girls need to, first of all, it starts with parents. It starts with family. I was very fortunate to be raised in a family. My mother is sitting right here, but I was very fortunate to be raised in a family where there was no difference between my brother and me. I could imagine being an astronaut, and it was okay. I could imagine being a scientist, and it was okay. I could imagine being whatever I wanted, and I was never told ki har ladki banna hi karti hai. Those mindsets, where we value our girl child, and we say that you know what, dream. And imagine, and then schools, teachers, communities, after parents, it goes into schools and teachers, where girls are given a safe environment to dream big, to think big, to value themselves. That is how empowerment will happen. And that's the one big thing that I have noticed everywhere in the world with women. As soon as you give girls, because we can do it, girls can do it. But we just are in a world which has been a patriarchal society for such a long time, that we need that little bit of support and a little bit of push, and then the world is their oyster. And as working with UNICEF, I've had such an incredible opportunity to meet such wonderful girls around the world who have taken their destinies in their own hands. Because you have partner organizations like UNICEF and so many others. You have the government, like the government of India, is like we just spoke about the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign, which is so massive in helping girls around the country find their strength. And that is how they get empowered. I remember we had gone to, I think in Maharashtra as well, there was this one girl, both her parents, very poor family, lived in a Jhopadpatti. And both her parents were unwell, very sick. And her mother used to stitch clothes. So sewing machine was in her room. And she was pulled out of school because the brothers had to go to school. Because they couldn't afford to send so many children to school. So she wanted to study. So her mother said, father ka bhi khayal rakhna hai, meri bhi tabiyat kharab hai, how can I send you also to school? Where is this money going to happen? So this girl started learning how to sew. And this is because she used to go to an Anganwadi, a UNICEF provided safe area where she could talk and learn life skills, learn financial independence. My mother, since I was a child, since I was 10 years old, always told me, you have to be financially independent. Every girl needs to be financially independent. And that is something I tied, to myself for a really long time. And this girl, she started learning how to sew. Slowly she became an entrepreneur in her village. She started making clothes, blouses, petticoats for women, jo fields mein kaam karne jaate hain, jinke paas kaam zyada apne liye kaam karne ke liye nahi hota tha, shaadiyon mein kapde banane lagi, and she created a little business. Slowly she had like 4 sewing machines and girls who used to come for 2-3 hours after school and help, and they created a little business where she goes to school and she sent her brothers to college and afforded her parents our parents' healthcare. That's all it takes. It takes empowering a girl and telling her you can do it. It's telling the boys in our country to look at girls like that, to look at